Hi. In this video, we would look into how an FM system is affected by non-linear channel as compared to an AM system. So we would select a channel, and based on that selection, we would perform some mathematical analysis and draw some conclusions. Afterwards, we would also validate our analysis by means of a simulation using Simulink environment. So let us consider FM system first. So we have a broadcast station that is transmitting a frequency modulated signal GFM of T. This signal passes through a non-linear channel. So this channel, what it does is it takes the input, multiplies it with the coefficient A1, and again takes the input, squares it and multiplies it with A2. For the third time, it takes the input signal, takes a cube of it, multiplies with coefficient A3, and finally the non-linear channel would add all of these components together, and then it will give that as an output. So the EMT wave is received at the antenna terminal, and the estimated frequency modulated signal, which I have expressed as G hat FM of T, is achieved over here. Now, once we achieve GFM of T, we will pass it through an appropriate band pass filter that's around plus minus FC, and then use over here some demod scheme, for example discriminator or a phase lock loop, and eventually we will get the estimated message signal M hat of T. So let us look into some of the mathematical aspects, starting with the transmitted signal, which is GFM of T. So in our prior discussions, we have expressed that it is equivalent to A cos omega CT plus the sensitivity parameter KF and the integration of message signal M of alpha D alpha. Note that we have a T here rather than an infinity in the integration. So either ways, this message signal GFM of T passes through this non-linear channel, and it is received at the antenna. So the estimated frequency modulated signal at the receiver side would be the input multiplied by coefficient A1. This is expressed as the first term. In the second term, take the square of the input and multiply it with coefficient A2. In the third term, take the cube of the input and multiply it with coefficient A3. So this is the comprehensive estimated signal at the output of an antenna terminal for the FM receiver. In order to understand it further, we can simplify it by using trigonometric properties such as cos square of theta, that would be equivalent to 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 cos 2 theta. And similarly, cos cube theta would be equivalent to cos square theta times cos theta, right? So if you multiply them, they would become cos cube theta. So in the second equality, I have done those simplifications. So if you open this square, you would have 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 cos 2 theta. So that I have expressed over here. There should be a square here, but for the simplicity of expressing notations, the 2 over here is omitted. Similarly, for the cube, you would have this expression, that is cos square theta times cos theta. Next, we will sort all of these terms with respect to their frequencies. Initially, we can observe that over here A2 A by 2. So this is not multiplied by any sinusoid. So this is a constant term, right? So this would contribute towards our DC content, that is A2 A by 2. After that, we have a frequency centered around omega CT. For that, we know that we have a first term in the second equality, which is centered at around omega CT. And we also have a term over here, which is cos omega CT. So this, for the from the third term in the second equality, we can multiply this inside the bracket with 1 and with the coefficient. So we would get one part of this one. This is 3 by 4, but over here we have A3A by 2. So this 3A3A by 4, this you can achieve by simply multiplying this term with the second term over here. That is, if you multiply, let me just call all of this argument as alpha and this argument as beta. So you would have cos of alpha times cos of beta. And from the trigonometric property, we know that cos alpha cos beta is equal to 1 by 2 cos alpha minus beta plus 1 by 2 cos alpha plus beta. So this is expressed, if you simplify it further, and then you would get 3A3A by 4. And mind you, again, there will be some power over here because it's an FM signal and the amplitude is not varying with respect to time. So I'm just, for simplicity, I'm not giving the powers over here, but they would be there. And similarly, we would have the terms for 2 mega CT and for 3 omega CT. Now what we would do is we would pass them through our, so if you use a band pass filter, so the DC content would cancel off, the content at around 2 mega CT would cancel off, and for the higher frequencies would be cancelled off. So you would be left with this one, right? So you can, after the filter, this is the only term that would be left. So you pass it through a demodulator and eventually you will get the estimate m hat of t, right? So even though we had a non-linearity, but still we are able to achieve the message signal. Note that these coefficients a1a plus 3a3a by 4 are independent of time. So this shows that the nonlinear channel has no or marginal effect on the frequency modulated signal. Moreover, there is an important feature over here. In our prior discussions, we mentioned that generating wideband FM is quite difficult. So because of this non-linear channel, we have wideband FMs at higher frequencies over here and over here. So as a byproduct, because of the non-linear channel, we are receiving a wideband FM. Now consider this with an AM system. Again, we have a broadcast station which has GAM of T. It passes through the same non-linear channel. We have an antenna, and then we have an estimate of the AM signal, and then we would pass it through an appropriate band pass filter. We would use a circuit over here that would do the demodulate of AM, and eventually you would get the estimate of the message signal. GAM of T is simply M of T cos omega CT, message signal times cos omega CT. So this would pass through this channel, so you would have the first term, the second term, and the third term. So again, you can open that by means of trigonometric properties in the second equality, and in the third equality you can sort as per the frequency components. So we have a DC content over here, and we have a signal which is at omega CT and omega 2 omega CT and 3 omega CT. But since we have applied a band pass filter, so this can be rejected, this can be rejected, and this can be rejected. So we would be left with the second term, right? So you can use a demodulator to eventually get back the M of T. But the concern is that the coefficient, this coefficient, is now dependent on time. You have M of T and you have M cube of T. So there are two signals which are added together, and for AM you have to detect the message signal from the amplitude. So this coefficient will induce significant distortion in the received signal. As a validation of FM versus AM in terms of non-linearity, let us use a Simulink environment to get some further insights. So in the Simulink environment, we have created the same setup as discussed previously for the analysis purpose. For reproducibility, I would click on all the boxes so that the results can be reproduced. First and foremost, all of these blocks can be obtained from the browser, Simulink library browser. So for this setup, I have used a triangular wave generator, which has a frequency of simply 1 Hz, and sampling time is set to 1/1000. Then this is passed through a frequency FM modulator passband. For that, I have set the carrier frequency to 10 Hz and the deviation to 3 Hz. For FM modulator, I have a demodulator with similar setup, 10, 3 and Hilbert transform filter order of 100. Over here, we have the nonlinear channel. For the nonlinear channel, I have set all the coefficients A1, A2 and A3 equal to 1. So over here, I have a direct link. That is the input directly fed to the summation block. This is our summation block. And then the input is passed through a squaring device. And then it is fed to the summation block. And for cube, I have used the input of the squaring device and multiplied it with the direct link, so that we have square times the original term, then it will become cube. So we have direct link, square and cube. So this is fed to the demod block, passed through a low pass filter. And sent to the scope. Also fed to the scope is an input signal. Now for analysis, I have also incorporated the design of AM over here. So we have a DSB AM. The same channel. And then DSB AM demodulator with these configurations, and then it is fed to the scope. Now let us run this experiment. So let us see the results. So the first waveform is our message signal m of t. The second waveform is m hat of t obtained by the demodulation using FM, while the third waveform is from AM. So it is evident over here that we have recovered our original signal to a good degree using FM as compared to AM. So for the sake of further understanding, we know that because of the non-linearity, this is a term that is affecting the AM system. So the AM system should work perfectly if we set A3 equal to 0. That is, this term is cancelled. Now let us visualize this aspect again in the Simulink environment. So I would cancel off this link, that is the cube link for both AM and FM. So this deletion will reflect on setting A3 equal to 0. So now if we run the experiment, we observe that now AM is also tracking the input signal to a good degree, whereas the performance of FM demodulated signal is also comparable.